I've got a new favourite constant to tell you about.
Another one?
Ah, constant. You love a number. So, let me write it out. Here's my new favourite constant. 2.920050977316. Going on forever. That's my new favourite constant because, kind of magically, this is going to create prime numbers for us. We're going to use this constant and this formula. We're going to create a sequence of numbers, and the next number in your sequence will be taking the previous number in your sequence. We're going to round it down, and that's what that symbol means. It's called the floor function. You round it down to the nearest integer, and then we'll multiply that by taking the previous number in the sequence, subtracting the integer part, so I guess it's the decimal part, we'll add one to that. And this is going to give us a sequence of prime numbers, especially when we're gonna round them down as well. We're gonna use that floor function. I'm gonna prove it. We'll start with the constant. So that's gonna be the first number in our sequence. Let's start with F1. First number in my sequence is this thing, 2.9200 and the rest. And by the way, I will point out that if I round this down, it's the first prime. It's 2. Great. Let's try the next number in my sequence. I've got my formula here, just saying take the previous number, round it down, so it means 2. Take the decimal part and add 1. So it's going to be multiplying by this, 1.9200. And the rest, that is going to give me the next number. It's 3.840109 and stuff. But that's the next prime number we were after. It's 3, okay. So we're hoping this is going to work as well. 3, and then yeah, 1 plus the decimal part, 1.840 and stuff. What's it going to be? It's going to be 5, that's good news, and some junk at the end of it.
Pretty important junk though.
It's going to be important junk. That's why I'm writing it out. We need this junk. Let's see if it keeps going. We're hoping for a 7. So we can take the integer part, which was 5. We take the decimal part with a 1 point, and then the rest, 5203058 is equal to, what's it going to be? 7.601529 and decimal junk. One more, or are you satisfied? Do you believe me?
Oh, let's do another one.
Okay, so what do we want the next one to be? So we've got 3, 5, 7.
11.
It should be 11, okay. So we take our previous one, which is a 7, 1 plus junk. And if you do your calculation, yes, 11.210705 and stuff.
And this constant never fails.
And this is never failing. So there is this constant somewhere out there in the world of numbers with this formula, which will give you every prime number in order as well, not missing one. Every prime number, 2, 3, 5, 7, 11, 13, and forever. And this constant, great, was found by a viewer, Numberphile viewer, who was inspired by one of my previous Numberphile videos. I have talked about constants that generate prime numbers before. And I did a video about something called Mill's constant. So Mill's constant was a constant and a formula in the same kind of way, which was this. I'm gonna call it A, and it was 1.306377883863 and stuff. So this was Mill's constant, and the formula was kind of like this is rounding down. It was Mill's constant to the power 3 to the power n, and then you would round that down. It gave you a sequences of primes. I'll show you what they are. So the first prime you got for doing this was a 2, then the next one was 11, then the next one was 1,361, and the next one was, oh, it was a big number. It was 2,521,008,887. And then the next one was huge, right? Really, really big. And so it's generating a sequence of primes, although there are gaps. There are gaps in this sequence. And they get really big as well. So one of our viewers saw that video. So that's Julie Gabulski. And he was at high school at the time, and he wasn't impressed. Because, oh yeah, well, it generates primes, but big gaps, huge primes. He wondered, could he make a constant so he could get all the primes, bam, 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 in order as well. So he came up with this idea. And he started calculating this constant with some of his friends. So it's Bruno, Dylan, Massey. And they created this. I've never seen this before. I love it. However, I can tell you now, it's not predictive. This is not going to be able to tell me primes I don't already know. I'm afraid Mill's constant is the same. We are actually using the primes to create this constant. It exists somewhere out there. I'm afraid I just don't know what it is. I'm sure creating prime constants doesn't have to be that hard. You can just have 0.2351113. That's a prime generating constant. It's not a very interesting one, though, is it? It's not very fun. And it's not very surprising. And I think this is kind of fun and surprising. And it does use properties of primes. They baked in the primes here using particular properties of primes. I want to show you what they've done here.
So it's more a case that the primes are generating the constant rather than the constant generating the primes.
I'm afraid you've caught me out. Yes, it's the primes generating the constant. I mean, it exists somewhere out there. It would be lovely if we could calculate it and then we could use it to predict primes. I'm afraid that's not the way it works.
So the number of decimal places we know this constant to depends on the number of primes we know.
Exactly, yeah. I'm afraid we are limited by how many primes we know. But I do like it. I do think it's kind of fun and surprising. So it's a cute little constant.
Have they given it a name?
I don't think they've given it a name. I knew you were going to give it a name. Oh. Brady loves giving things names.
I do. But they have the right to name it.
They do.
Yeah. But, you know, if they don't hurry up, I might jump on the bandwagon.
Brady's going to do it first. So we'll see the title of this video. What has Brady decided? So let's see how they made it. So when I saw this, I actually really enjoyed reverse engineering how they did it. But and you might try that yourself. But I might give you the ingredients that you need. And then you can see perhaps for yourself how they did it. First of all, I'm going to tell you what a general term in the sequence looks like. We were calling those FN. I'm going to show you how to write FN in terms of prime numbers. It actually looks like this. It's the nth prime. And then we're going to subtract one. And then the next term we're going to add on is the next prime number. So it's the n plus 1 prime. Subtract one. And divide that by the nth prime. And then for the next term, you take the next prime number, which is prime number with the n plus 2 subscript there. We subtract one again, and we're going to divide by the previous primes, pn plus 1, pn.
Multiply by each other, yeah?
Yeah, so we're dividing by this, multiply by that, yes, exactly. And so you can see what the next term might be. So the next one is going to be the next prime number, still with subtract one, and then dividing by the previous primes we've got, so these prime numbers. And that's the pattern that goes on forever. So if you wanted to work out the first one, which is our special constant, F1, we'll start with the first prime. So that would be 2 minus 1 plus, and then you take the next prime, 3 minus 1 now, divided by 2. And then it's going to be the next prime up, 5 minus 1, divided by our previous primes. And then next prime up, divided by our previous primes. And that's going to be our constant that I told you at the beginning, 2.9 whatever. So those are our starting ingredients. And then this really important observation. We're going to use a property of primes called Bertrand's postulate. It's a big thing actually when you're studying primes. If you've got the nth prime, the next prime is obviously bigger, but it is smaller than twice the nth prime. I'm not going to do the proof for you. It's totally possible to do for yourself. When I heard about this constant, I thought it was great. I loved it. I thought it was good fun. I went looking to see if anyone had done it before. And I've not seen anyone do it before, but I did find it in one place, in a kind of completely different context. I found it somewhere, which is with this sequence, something slightly different. We're going to look for the smallest prime that doesn't divide n. That doesn't divide n.
So it's not a factor of n.
So it's not a factor of n. So for 1, the smallest prime that doesn't divide 1 is 2. Smallest prime that doesn't divide 2 is 3. The smallest prime that doesn't divide 3 is 2. Smallest prime that doesn't divide 4 is 3. Smallest prime that doesn't divide 5, 2. Smallest prime that doesn't divide 6, can't be 2, can't be 3. That one's a 5. And then it's a 2 here, and a 3 here, and so on. So that's a sequence. Smallest primes that don't divide n. And if you look at the average of this sequence, and this is going on forever, but if you took the average of this sequence, it is my new favorite constant.
It's the prime generator.
It's the prime generator, completely different sequence. This is going on forever. So we're looking at what the average tends to. To work out the average, you look at the proportion of these numbers that are two. And so, and half of them are, half of these numbers are two. Then you would look at the proportion of these numbers that are a three. And if you look there, you can work out the proportion of threes. Look at the proportions of fives. And using those numbers, you can add them up. You can find the average of the sequence.
Do you want to learn more about prime numbers and divisibility? Or how about any of these subjects? Look, no matter what you're into, Brilliant is going to have the quizzes, problems, entire courses for you that are fun, interactive, and lovingly designed to engage your brain, to make you smarter. These aren't like homework or some kind of chore. They're fun, they're stimulating, they're created by people who really know their stuff. By the way, Brilliant, loving the new design. Such a great looking site. Go to brilliant.org/numberphile to see more and get 20% off a premium subscription that accesses everything on the site. That's brilliant.org/numberphile. Sign up for yourself, or maybe give Brilliant as a gift.